theories are now that it is more likely than not that we are existing in a multiverse, which is more than one universe parallel. And it is possible that in the other multiverse there are higher forms of life. Is it possible to be reincarnated from this universe to another multiverse or to a different world? And how does it fit in with the whole reincarnation theory and moksha? And does it have add another dimension to the whole thing?
Can we add this as well? Because this question is equally relevant. It's from another gentleman. No, this one.
That's the one. That's the one I asked.
Oh, you asked that one. That's okay. Okay. Now, let me just tidy up. First of all, the reason why we use the word multiverse or parallel universe is has come out of modern physics. As modern physics is struggling with the idea of quantum, it's a real mystery and it's a real killer for the modern physicists. They have kind of decided to fall back on this idea that while I'm talking to you, infinite copies of ourselves are parting from each other because one electron jumps slightly different. So the whole universe, the whole creation multiplies itself and moves away. Just because there's a light variation, that's the only way they can respond to the issue of quantum. So they are kind of focusing on this multiverse scenario while we are talking infinite copies are moving away. Now look, this is absolute nonsense. It is really divergence with a vengeance because you don't have a proper answer. You are kind of falling back on this kind of nonsensical idea that the universe is breaking up at every instant of the time. This is the problem of modern physics, modern cosmology. Fair enough. Hinduism doesn't agree with that. The other idea that you are suggesting in this particular question is that do we believe in different levels of existence? Mm-hmm. Yes, we do. Hindus have always believed that just as you are so comfortable about this particular level of existence, this empirical world, where we share the same universe, the same sun and the moon and so on, and all the different colored human beings and so on, we are sharing the same universe. In the same way, there can be other levels and layers of existence. We agree with that. Look, I have not experienced that, so I have no further comment, except we agreed with that. And the kind of language you hear is the word Dev Lok, means people of higher beings living on existing on a different plane, you know, kind of different level of existence. Dev Lok means higher, made of light, divya. The second word you will perhaps hear is the Pitru Lok, means people who passed away in your own family, kind of coexist on a different plane. So we believe in different layers of existence, that is true, but that's not the same idea as the multiverse scenario in modern physics. Please don't mix them up. Okay, now this issue of how does it interact with the idea of reincarnation? According to me, this is just really a theory because I have not experienced this higher lok and I don't want to actually, I'm quite happy here. We are saying that if you are kind of a person with higher aspirations, very idealistic, very spiritually oriented, when you pass away, because you kind of are fed up with this kind of very mundane world, you kind of exist in a much higher level of existence where you interact with people at that level. And so it's a much more, perhaps less cantorous universe, and we call it Dev Lok. But again, this is not permanent Hinduism. This is not heaven in the kind of Abrahamic tradition. We basically kind of go there for a short period and we realize that this still doesn't satisfy, and then we become reincarnated as human beings. This is our theory. Or you might go to the Pitri Lok where you meet your, you know, dead relatives, etc. Now it may sound very nice because one of the youngsters was asking me, I loved my father, he's passed away. Can I meet him when I pass away? Look, if you've got so much intense love for your father who has passed away, it is highly likely, I don't give you any promises, that you will end up in this Pitri Lok and you will see your parents and your father, etc. But my question to you, my friend, is this. When they're alive, interacting with you here, that's the best time to interact. When they've passed away, suppose you meet them in the Pitri Lok, tell me, just try and imagine a Pitri Lok. You meet your dead relatives and you kind of smile and you light up and you embrace each other and you cry, tears of joy hopefully, and you cry and you hug and so on. What afterwards? What? For how long will you keep crying and hugging? Tell me. What else? So even Pitri Lok sounds like a good idea, meeting your dead. What will you do there? How long will you keep, you know, hugging them and kissing them and whatever? So this world that we live in, here, when you go to your pitrus here, when you go to your parents here, interact with them vibrantly, you know, like Nishit Bhai loves his mom, I know. So interact with your parents in a very vibrant manner here and now, rather than wait for them to go to Pitri Lok and go and meet up there. Why do you want to do that? Interact with the living world that we are interacting here with. This is my idea. And we do have this idea that you can be reincarnated from the higher level to the human level, and from the human level go to the Pitri Lok or the higher level. And there is the highest level is called Brahma Lok. And that's something highly spiritual.